Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. The NBA draft is fast approaching, coming up on June 23rd. And while the Lakers don't have any picks in the draft as of this moment, I would be surprised if the night ended that way. They're going to have about $4 million to spend. Rob Pelinka has already said they would like to buy a second-round pick. With $4 million, maybe even they could buy 2 second-round picks. Maybe that's a little bit optimistic. But in any event, the Lakers will attempt to buy their way into the draft, pick up a second rounder, and then go from there. And this franchise has historically done great finding players late in the draft. They have a long list of guys that they found, including Talen Horton-Tucker, who's on the team right now. Austin Reeves as well is another player. Think about Jordan Clarkson, Thomas Bryant. They've found a number of guys late in the draft that wound up being solid rotation players in the NBA. So I would be surprised if the Lakers don't wind up buying a second round pick and then attempting to land some talent from there. But that is not the only way. It's not just buying a pick, not just grabbing a player in the first or second round, that they can actually add talent in the NBA draft. And yes, there's trades as well, which is part of what makes draft night so much fun around the NBA. There's going to be plenty of trade talks for the Lakers to get involved in. But no, I'm talking about when the draft is over. You see, the Lakers are going to be one of, if not the top landing spot, period, for undrafted free agents. And at first glance, you think, well, if the player didn't get drafted in the first 60, well, this year it's going to be 58 picks because the Bulls and the Miami Heat both lost their second round picks due to some business that they got involved with, chatting a little bit too early with Lonzo Ball and Kyle Lowry in free agency. So they were punished by losing their second round picks. So only 58 picks. But on the surface, you look at it and you say, well, if a guy wasn't good enough to get drafted in the first two rounds, then how much of an impact can he really make? But actually, undrafted free agency can yield some talent. I mean, look, Austin Reeves being a great example. And essentially, there's two reasons why the Lakers will be the top, in my mind, the top landing spot for undrafted free agents. And again, Austin Reeves is number one. You look at what HBK did last year. Austin Reeves had the chance to be drafted in the second round, and he very wisely said, no, you know what? As much as I'd like to hear my name called on draft night, I want to make sure I go to a place where if I do something, it's going to matter. People are going to notice what I can do, and I'm going to have opportunities to show what I can do. And he had a chance to be drafted by the Detroit Pistons in the second round. He said, no, thank you. Please do not draft me. And instead opted to fall out of the draft so he could go to the Los Angeles Lakers. Typically, these things are already set up before the draft is actually over, which is why as soon as the draft ends, you start to see, I'm talking about the moment it ends, Adrian Wojnarowski, Shams Charania, Mark Stein, Chris Haynes, these guys all start tweeting out where different undrafted free agents are going. They have these deals set up ahead of time. Hey, if you don't get drafted, you're going to come to this team, right? They set up those deals well in advance. So Austin Reeves knew he was going to go to the Lakers and preferred that option over going to the Pistons because, again, he rationalized that going to the Lakers, the spotlight is going to be brighter and perhaps there's going to be more opportunities. So if he's able to get on the floor and play meaningful minutes and show what he can do, it would matter more in a Lakers uniform than it would in the uniform of the Detroit Pistons. And so I think a lot of other free agents, guys who don't get drafted, they're going to look at that and they're going to say, yeah, look, Austin Reeves, look what he did. He set himself up now where a year from now, next summer, when he's a free agent, he's probably getting paid. We'll see what he does this summer, but he has now put himself on a path to get potentially a bigger contract than what most second round guys would get, maybe even a contract bigger than most of the guys that are in the first round would get, depending on what he does this season. So I think a lot of guys are going to look at what Austin Reeves did and the choice he made to go to the Lakers, go to a place where the spotlight is going to be on you if you're able to be successful. And that is going to help the Lakers out because these guys are going to see the value with going to the purple and gold. But Austin Reeves aside, and I think that's reason number one, why the Lakers will be the top landing spot for undrafted free agents. But reason number two is look at the Lakers roster right now. Not only are there not very many spots filled as of this moment, even if the Lakers pick up options on everybody, we're talking about, what, 8 guys that they'll have under contract right now? That's a lot of spots that are open. And then factor in that it's a very weak free agency class. It's a very thin free agency class. And the Lakers don't have a lot of spending power. Assuming Russell Westbrook sticks around next season, we're looking at a Lakers team that has the taxpayer mid-level exception, which is going to be about $6 million, and then veteran minimums. That's it. That's all they've got to spend to go round out their roster. So if you're an undrafted free agent, not only do you have the example that Austin Reeves set last season, but you've got potentially opportunity to come in and win minutes. And I think that is what's going to really put the Lakers over the top. Again, I expect them to be the top landing spot for undrafted free agents. I would be very surprised if when the draft ends, when pick number 58 gets announced, I would be surprised if the Lakers weren't the landing spot for a number of undrafted free agents. Now, that doesn't mean that those guys are automatically given spots or automatically given two-way contracts or whatever. For most of these guys, what's going to happen is they're going to get added to the summer league team. The Lakers, again, I think will have their choice of a lot of the undrafted guys, and this draft should have some intriguing players that go undrafted, and then they get added to summer league. They do well there. They'll be brought into the regular season, or they'll be brought into preseason play. They'll have to go through training camp. Things go well there. Then they can play a little bit in preseason and then maybe make the regular season roster. So there's still a lot of steps to go through. So even if you see on draft night, let's say Woj drops a bomb and says, player X signs with the Los Angeles Lakers, don't start penciling that guy in to the roster for next season just yet. Still have a long way to go to actually make the regular season roster. But again, I would expect the Lakers to have a very, very good opportunity to land some talented players. Again, these guys are not all going to hit. Low hit probability after the draft ends with undrafted guys, but I would expect the Lakers to have essentially their pick of the undrafted free agents that they'd like to add, and that could bring some intriguing talent a la Austin Reeves from last season. But Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts on the draft. What do you want to see the Lakers do? Do you think they can buy a second round pick? And then undrafted free agency. Do you agree with me that the Lakers offer opportunity and history that makes them the top choice for undrafted free agents? Give me your thoughts in the comments down below. And don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Till next time, see ya and stay safe.